We kept things relatively simple in the beginner's tutorial by focusing solely on the native aspects of Renoise. In this video though, we'll take a look at using external third-party plugins, which come in the file types of VST, Audio Units, LADSPA and DSSI. Renoise looks for installed plugins in two locations, which can be set in the Preferences menu under the Plug Miscellaneous tab. So, it's a good idea to organise all of your plugins into one or two folders. Here you can see I've installed mine into different locations for 32 and 64-bit plugins. Renoise will automatically scan for plugins when you set these locations, and by default, also on startup. If you've installed a plugin while Renoise is active, or if for some reason a plugin is not showing up, you can just hit the rescan button to check the folders again. There are two different types of plugin: effects and instruments. Plugin effects are found in the effects list beneath the native devices, and can be applied to individual tracks, which affects everything that's played in that track. They can also be directly applied to one or more of an instrument's samples, which is done in the Effects tab of the sampler. Here, the plugin effects can be inserted into various effects chains, which are then assigned to the desired samples. Plugin effects come with their own external editor for accessing their specific parameters. Different plugins perform different functions, so each one features its own custom interface. You can make changes to the plugin here, or you can access the parameters directly through the Renoise interface, adjusting them in much the same way as the native effects. And just like the native effects, you can insert parameter change commands into the pattern editor with the right mouse button. As well as creating changes through automation. A Renoise instrument can produce sounds from three different sources, one of which are plug-in instruments. If you need clarification on how this works, please see our An Introduction to Instruments video. Just like the plug-in effects, plug-in instruments come with their own custom editors. If you'd like to keep the editor open when you're not working in the plugin tab, just deselect the pin button and click again to reattach it. The plugin's current program can be selected here from the various presets that come included with the instrument. Not all plugins support this though, so in those cases, the changes have to be made within the editor. You can load and save individual program presets, as well as all of the presets at once as a bank. The plugin's volume and bass note can be adjusted with these options. Auto suspend toggles the automatic suspension of an instrument when it is no longer playing, which saves CPU power. The channel number is the MIDI channel used to trigger the plugin. Some plugins can use this to play different programs through different channels, which are selected and set up using the external editor. Note that the method for doing this will be different for every plugin instrument, so you'll need to find that information by referring to the manual of that specific instrument. Using the audio routing option, a plugin instrument can be assigned directly to a specific track. Now, even though the notes are played from track 1, the audio is being routed to track 3. This is very useful when performing live, where the notes are not pre-recorded. You can just select the instruments you need and play them on the keyboard without worrying about moving the cursor to different tracks in the pattern editor. Some plugins offer additional routing options, as they have more than one output bus. Again, the method of assigning these outputs will be different for every plugin. Now you can see on the scopes that they're playing on separate tracks. This is great, but what use are the multiple outputs when we still need to load in another copy of the plugin to use multiple channels? Well, we can get around this by making use of a plugin alias. Click on a new instrument slot, go back to the plugin tab, then open VST alias and double click on the instrument you need. By the way, the aliases are shown here as VSTs, but this also applies to audio units, LADSPA and DSSI devices. An alias is a reference to the original instrument, so they will be affected by any changes made in the external editor or the plugin properties, with the exception of transpose and the channel number. So, you can now change the channel number in each alias to use different programs with just one single instance of a plugin instrument. Not all instruments can make use of plugin aliasing, but if they can, it's worth doing instead of loading multiple new versions of the same instrument, because it will save on both CPU power and memory. While most plugin instruments output actual audio, others can output MIDI commands to control other instruments. This is handled with the MIDI routing option. Note that the target instrument must be below the source in the instrument selector. And that the target instrument doesn't have to contain a plugin itself. It can also make use of samples and/or MIDI. You can also target another plugin that outputs MIDI creating a chain of MIDI generating plugins. Plugin instruments have a lot of great qualities, but there are a couple of disadvantages. When sharing a Renoise song, the other user must have that plugin installed on their system as well. And this is something that's also true for plugin effects. The second disadvantage is that plugins can only make use of a limited number of effect commands. So, if you'd like to take the sounds from a plugin and use them as samples, then Renoise offers this ability with the Render to Samples feature. This is quite a lengthy topic with a lot of options, so we'll cover this fully in another video. And on a final note, if you're having trouble getting a specific plugin to work properly, click the question mark button. It presents you with a few options which you can change to try to get the plugin to behave.